With Championship Saturday almost here, it's time we find out who'll be playing this weekend's finals. Tonight, 10 teams from across the Champlain Valley punched their ticket to the respective championships, although some took a little longer to get there. Start with Division I boys semifinals, Hartford and Colchester, both looking to get to the final game for the first time since the 90s. Closing seconds of the first half, ball set in front and punched in by Matt Gowdy. Colchester takes a 2-0 lead before the break, or do they? The officials actually talk it over, and they agree that the time expired before the ball crossed the line. No goal. Lakers' halftime lead is just 1-0. Second half, time ticking down in Hartford's season. One last chance. Corner kick. Bounced around. Finds its way into the net. Goes in off a Colchester player. Own goal. The Hurricanes will make it a 1-1 game with just over 2 minutes to play in regulation. Ends that way, so bonus soccer allows the goalies to shine. Great saves all around. Aaron Parker of Rutland was tested throughout as the Lakers carried the play. But their own keeper, Liam Mooney, would also feel the overtime pressure, saving perhaps the season for Colchester and many saves in overtime. Finally, the Lakers would get what they came for. Ball moved around well. Ending on the foot of Matt Brin, scoring the game-winning goal. Colchester wins 2-1 in overtime. The crowd goes wild. But wait a minute, not so fast. Offsides is called. The goal doesn't count. We're going to play into an extra frame. We go to that second overtime of the game. Gowdy, who had one taken away at the end of the first half, goes on one-on-one. Ball keeps going into the net. This time, it counts. Ball game. Drive home safely. Lakers do win 2-1 in double overtime.
I just remember the ball being played. Terrific ball in. And I was going to look right, and he just went to the right. I just played in bottom left corner, and just went nuts. Awesome.
Just before the end of this game, it was announced that CVU won their game, so it will be the Lakers and the Redhawks for the Division I Boys Soccer State Championship Saturday at Buckhart Field in Burlington. Girls playoff soccer, back to George Brendler Field we go for the second night in a row. Chazy hosting Minerva-Newcomb in the Class D girls semifinal. First half action, another goal that would try to beat the halftime buzzer. Rachel Pombrio beats the horn with the team's second goal of the game. There were 4 seconds left in the half, 2-0 Eagles. Second half, Astasia Myler was hard to get past. With every shot Chazy threw at her, she knocked it down, making a save for the Mountaineer keeper. Some big saves at that, leading to stop after stop. 25 saves in all for Myler, and it seemed to be just in the second half alone. The only thing that she lacked maybe perhaps a little was another inch or two in her vertical jump, because Kinnan Latrimore fires it right over her from downtown. Bang, 3-0 Chazy. That would be enough for the Eagles as they will get Mariah, who won earlier today. They'll face each other in this coming championship Saturday.
The last game they really, really did well, so it will be a tough team to beat. We just wanted to, like, create space and make sure we capitalize on a goal, and we did that.
The Class D girls' final will kick off at Plattsburgh's Athletic Complex 5 p.m. right before the boys' game at 7. Coming up tomorrow night, the Class C finals get going also at PHS with Seton and NAC in the girls' action, while the NAC Bobcat boys play Lake Placid.